Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, virtual wrestling fans of all ages, we welcome you to DCA Wildcats episode 22. Eddie Mack is me, along with DC's People's Champ, and Josh McCloud, and holy shit, that is a lot to digest, guys.
What the hell going on around here? That's crazy. A free fall cell match, though. That's crazy, though.
Yes, it is.
Wow. That's a huge announcement to open the show.
Eddie, you and I were a part of one of only two Freefall Hell in a Cell matches ever.
Yeah, that being between Dallas and Sergeant Clements. That ended both of their careers. Why'd you have put one career on hold? That ended, it ended the other.
Yeah, it happened at, what was it, SDA Defiance.
Yep.
2012, I believe.
Yep, 2012.
Look at this. Star Sisters. Man.
Starstruck, as they're calling themselves now.
We kick off the night with the first match of the evening at Starstruck. Taylor and Sophia Star take on the Kid and Kazarin. It's assumed that Suzumi will be at their side tonight.
I hope they're still wearing that ugly-ass white outfit she had on last time I seen that shit.
Why you go, whoa, this is my first time seeing it, and you're already judging people's appearance?
Hey, I've seen her shit, I've seen her shit before, shit is ugly.
Eddie, man, who invited
the dude?
Into my place? I'm the voice of DCA, goddammit.
That's nice. Okay, she looks a little bit better.
Here comes the Dynasty. Kazarin on the right, there's the Kid.
I remember Kazarin.
Unfortunately,
so do I. Yeah, I remember her. SDA. Kid, SDA.
Right.
Kid's a former SDA Queen of Roses champion.
Right.
Whereas on the other side, Taylor Starr is a former Miss Money in the Bank and CCL, former CCL Tag Champion, and also CCL Women's, former Women's Champion.
Right.
Matter of fact, she held both the women's and tag team championships at the same damn time.
And if I'm mistaken, I believe she is the last.
Yeah, she's the only woman in CCL history.
Right.
She's the only woman in CCL history to hold two championships at once. And only the fourth CCL superstar overall.
Oh, this fish here, lightning.
Still lightning.
Something else to digest,
Hold on.
Yes. Zell and the Kid, very familiar with one another.
Very much so.
Oh, it's Kazarin goes down.
I guess Kazarin wasn't protecting herself at all times like she's supposed to.
She was not.
Nope.
That's what she gets. Oh!
And there you go. Tail Star took it already.
Drop kick. Raises Kazarin, then Kazarin's about to be brought in the hard way.
One way to take your opponent in the ring.
Right hand sends Taylor down, and only a two counts.
You see, Taylor's in the wrong part of town right here.
Right. Quick question, guys.
Okay.
How the hell are Morgan and Palmer not going to touch buttons? Not going to be able to not touch one another.
Well, maybe, just maybe, they'll be adults and, you know, keep your hands off each other.
Yeah.
They're asking each other so much you'd swear they're horny teenagers. Good lord.
Alright, hey, listen. I'm just telling you, like, this sounds to me like that situation back in 2001 between Stone Cold Steve Austin and Triple H. It's almost a similar situation. They made it.
They were able to keep their hands off each other.
Yeah, exactly. They was able to do it, and I think. I mean, but I think this is just a different situation because Those two women, absolutely, they hate each other more than those two did. I mean, Pyra had Morgan taken out by Neo Diva Revolution and not being able to make it for their match at CCL Future Shop.
Mm-hmm.
And then at CCL Holiday Havoc, Morgan returned and cost Pyra the CCL Women's Championship. So these two women, they hate each other.
I mean, it's an issue that spans multiple promotions. Oh, as Ring Arbo is not on the mark there by Sophia and the kid back in. I have another question. It's in reference to the Road to Victory. Get the Zoomy down already! If I heard correctly, Emmy said there's a member of the Dynasty in the tournament.
Yeah, but who is that member?
I got $5 on the. I got $5 on the champion of the world.
So we're putting bets now or something?
I'm trying to figure out, like, what? You know what? That kind of makes sense, but at the same time, I'm like, okay. I don't
know. I mean, what better? Here as the kid focusing on the wrong opponent. Gonna cost her.
Swing and miss on the head, swing elbow, but wait a minute, the kid not able to react quickly enough there. Swap Packers.
Yeah, that was the second time she tried that handspring elbow and it just did not work.
You gotta reevaluate that. It's not working out for her. Wait a minute, the kid
off the distraction. Luthes pressing a couple of right hands. I've been told it is not the DCA Wildcats champion.
Though I think it would have been funny as hell if she was in that tournament to try to make sure no one else would try to challenge her. But at the same time, I think Akira wouldn't mind somebody challenging her because then it would be somebody else's ass to kick.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying.
Somebody else's career to end. I will press my guy Zarin in the near fall.
I like how Emmy was talking about.
One thing. After seeing her rise, I really hope Vanessa Price's career isn't actually over.
Yeah, I like how Envy said, oh, Vanessa Price can't be in the tournament because she's a former Wildcats champion. Hello? The woman is still in the damn hospital.
Yeah, that's kind of the big reason why, you know?
Right. And
her career might be over. Oh, yeah, I know, that's fine.
Yeah. I mean, there is that.
That old thing.
But we're just not going to talk about that, right?
No, we're not.
Yeah, I don't think
Russia led there by the Dynasty.
We're just my business.
It is our job as commentators to commentate the show, so nobody can judge us.
Yeah, I'm an award-winning commentator. I'll do it whatever way I want to. Fuck.
Champ and I play by a different set of rules.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not from your area, Carl. This is where decades lie. Now, wait a minute. That was completely messed up. It's where new areas of call collide. So.
Oh,
I'm a completely different end. If you've seen me, you know what end I'm talking about.
Oh,
man. Right in the face. That's a move that could easily break her jaw if done right.
In the face! Sorry. Every time somebody says that, I do that.
It's alright, Carter.
Oh! Man.
Wow!
That was awesome!
That might be it!
Oh, man. She's out flat. Sophia. I think that's Sophia. I didn't get a good look.
That's Sophia. Front two and Taylor breaks it up.
This sister saving little sister.
Well, guys, I have a question for you. What if Akira retains at the Mega Event and a Dynasty member wins the tournament?
Oh, that would be freaking interesting as hell.
Oh, that makes for some interesting conversation in the general manager's office, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Do you think that they would keep, their pack together, or would Dolly will be over when they throw away their team for the championship. I don't know about you guys, but if it came down to a championship or a faction, the championship always comes first.
We almost
had, this guy gets it.
Yo, we almost had a situation
speaking
like
as
that.
A wrestler, speaking as a wrestler, that's how I believe it works.
I agree with you 100%. I'm going to just say something. In CCO, we almost had a situation like that with the blacklist, with Maybelline Wolf becoming the number one contender and Pirate challenger for the women's championship, except for the fact that Morgan Rayquan might put a monkey wrench in those plans.
That was a man finally gets the tag to tell.
What?
Elbow sends the kid down.
Oh.
Any bitch slaps it. Oh, and kicks in the leg.
Taylor taking her down. I don't want to take her eyes off her opponent. Taylor. Oh, nice DDT.
Oh, look at Sarah. Somebody on it. Close one.
The ultimate equalizer going right for the eyes.
Oh, wait a minute.
Taylor. This is what we're like it's on.
Sophia was right there. Referee, man, he's broke.
Can't control here.
This thing is broken down here.
This is just the beginning of the show, ladies and gentlemen. You're just tuning in. It is the voice of DCA here on Wildcats 22 alongside Eddie Mack.
Wait a minute,
Taylor Starr.
Two gentlemen that need no introduction in this civilized world.
Oh, I thought it was a firebreaker.
Thank you, Eddie, by the way.
I was talking about you.
No. I understand. Go for the cup.
Tiger Pop, I got done, man.
What a kick out.
That was crazy. Taylor went right for that Starbreaker, but Kaizera found a way out of it and dropped it with a Tiger Bomb, but it only got a 2 count. That was a hell of a sequence there by these two women.
Taylor, oh my God.
That hurts.
Yes. That's...
Look.
Oh, that hurts!
The current CCL Women's Tag Champions who are trying to make a name for themselves here in Wildcats. Wait!
And they may have fought Starstruck, though. One, two,
together! Oh my
goodness. Wow! I don't think that was made to distract Starstruck, guys.
I don't think so either, but...
It did, though.
Yeah.
Oops. We're sorry, our bad. For me.
No, Eddie, don't blame us. We're just the commentators. We're here watching the action. If they got distracted by looking at me, then that's their problem.
Yeah, they got distracted looking at you. There's a reason for it. Okay.
Wait a minute.
Here they come. Cassandra Nova and Corey K.O. Owens look like they want to fight.
Yeah, because not so much.
Well, you should be surprised by that.
Well, that's a good point.
And look at Lightning.
Yeah, I think she's seen enough.
That's kind of putting a lot of weight on their shoulders.
I was starting to think if they didn't have it decided, then we're gonna have to play Rochambeau or something. Maybe sell it in a smash.
I think we've gotten plenty of that this season so far, Eddie.
Maybe they should have played Russian roulette to figure out who's going to be in the tournament. Okay.
Speaking of tournament, here's a Road to Victory qualifier match.
Now, here's the thing.
This is an interesting one.
Let me get it out.
That's not what she said. Okay.
Oh, my God.
With all the qualifying matches, nobody knows who they are facing until the time of the match. And this is Roxy Glock, one half of the Glock.
Now, as I was saying, this is an interesting one because not often you see a Glock competing in singles action.
I was getting to that, Josh.
You interrupted me.
My bad, but
I know you're big-time CCL guy, but I have the right to say something.
Okay, do I have to put y'all both in your separate corners and tell y'all to come out when I say so?
Wait a minute.
Let's chill out. Oh, you gotta be fucking...
Oh, my God.
Help us!
Wow. Tag team partners are going at it to try to get to this Road to Victory tournament.
Wow.
Boy, howdy.
This is Terra Glock. This is the other half of the Glock. I'm pretty sure this was not a random Glock. I'm going to go ahead and say it. I think there's something to put here. I eat shenanigans.
I mean, I won't complain. I kind of want to see this match.
Like, you say shenanigans, I say this is shinduckery.
I think it's brilliant.
Well, of course you would say it's brilliant. You're on the DCA panel.
I'd tip my hat to whoever decided to book this match.
Well, whoever booked this match is about to happen. The Glocks are getting ready to face each other, and the winner gets into the Road to Victory tournament. This is one of those situations that you hear about a lot when it comes to this wrestling business, is that, you know, whether your friends, family, what have you, if there's a chance to be a champion, damn it, you're going to take it.
Boxy with the short black hair, and Tara with the sporty look.
That mohawk, though.
Right. Well, here we go.
I think. I wonder if everybody here is going to start chatting to Tara that she looks stupid like Sheamus.
I don't know. Tara looks like she could beat up my cat this crowd.
Tara looks like she carry like some kind of firearm in her back pocket or something, dog.
Oh, no, I'm sure she does.
I mean, the bitch came out with a thing full of bullets. I know she got some kind of firearm.
I'm pretty sure that it's not for show. I'm
just saying. Hey.
Right.
She probably got a firearm or something. It's probably, she got a legal gun and an illegal gun somewhere posted up. Oh, goodness.
Well, aside of stuff that can get us sued, first time ever Roxy Glock taking on Terra Glock. And so far, it's been completely down the middle as expected.
There you go. Again, these two are a tag team. They've gone up and down the road. They've played together. They've lived together. I mean, so they know what the next other person going to do before they even do it.
They're not going to be surprised by a lot here in this match. Emily, winner of this whole Road to Victory tournament will be the number one contender. For the Wildcats Championship, they will get that opportunity at DCA Redemption. That's not the next CPD, that's the one after.
Well, essentially, whoever wins this tournament is basically going to be the next victim if Akira Yukimura comes out of Wildcats DXD as the champion.
This is an excellent point. I mean, let's not sugarcoat it.
I'm going to tell you something. Just watching these two. Wait.
Dude,
no. Just watching these two, it just reminds me of so many situations where you got tag team partners that go up against each other. Hell, there was a time I went up against a power bomb
by Terror.
I went up against a former tag team partner in like a 3-match series. It came down to a third matchup between the two of us, and we just knew everything we was going to do.
Well, I got similar experience, but see, me and him, I had this tag team partner once, and we fought, but cover one, two, take out a two, and we fought, but it wasn't exactly for a title, and it wasn't exactly out of respect.
Oh, hang on, so is that flip? Two, no, Terror versus it, two, and Roxy three versus it, two, and Terror four versus it. Five first by Roxy, and I'm not
going to
keep counting.
Yeah, fuck that. Are you serious?
A long story short, I kicked his ass.
There you go.
Three of these two.
Very evenly matched, as we thought they would be.
Evenly matched, both in wrestling ability and craziness.
Yeah, I think looking at these two, especially the one with the mohawk, I really don't think they would be very dateable.
Oh, look out!
No, well, no. It's a good thing this is a wrestling show and not Maury.
Yeah. Now they look like they would more be on Jerry Springer than Maury, though. Okay.
They actually do. Okay. But wrestling show, voice of DCA, right here at the table. For your entertainment. We got a gate roll.
Right the clock. Yep, I must end the
hole. Oh, okay. Roxy, uh-oh. Oh!
Wow.
That's just, yeah.
That was just disrespectful.
Like it's hooked in, Terrence still alive.
Well, I'm going to tell you something, though. Like, you got the voice of DCA here, and you have two award-winning commentators. You can't lose with this.
Man, you're the first person besides me that said, called me the voice of DCA. Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's official now. Wait a minute. Schoolboy. One, two. Kick out.
Look at the strength.
Oh, the strength of Roxy Glock.
Down.
Does she have it? This match, these two are so evenly matched.
What an uppercut!
I don't know what's gonna happen.
What's gonna happen is one of these two are gonna lose.
And that sucks.
That'll take a lot though. Whoa! Oh, what a hard fall.
People need to understand, when you hit that mat is still like almost like hitting concrete. That shit hurts.
Ouch. Ow. I know what that feels like.
Get the medic.
Yeah, especially when you do shit like a power bomb like that. Yeah, that's gonna hurt.
I kick out by Terror. Now Terra, try and get some momentum back. Wait a minute. What a DDT.
That was a beautiful DDT.
Executed. And Terra needs to quit laughing, control herself, because she can laugh after the match.
Speaking of which, I was going to ask. Oh, hang on.
But, whoa.
Two. After reversing, shoulders down.
69. Uh-oh. Okay, alright.
What?
Oh!
Oh my god!
Oh my
god. Oh, there goes Terra's head.
1, 2, and 3.
Wow.
Good night.
What a match.
Good night. So, make sure you tip your waitress on the way out.
Roxy Glock Oh boy.
That's 1-16 now.
I was gonna ask what will the future hold for the Galaxy? What will the future hold for the Galaxy unit following this?
I think honestly they may get stronger after this. You know, the whole what doesn't kill you makes you stronger shit.
Oh, now.
Are you ready? I just find that funny, though, that Michelle was like,
I earned the title match.
I was in winning the last couple weeks. Hey, I'm sorry, you lost last week. Well, that's fine, so, okay.
And now, we got a huge match coming up featuring the one and only DCA Sugar Mama and my number one sugar, Sugar Jones.
Yeah, this bitch.
There's no any for your Sugar Jones.
That was a hell of an introduction, I will say that.
This match made, apparently earlier today, and this is the second straight match that, that members of the tag team we faced off here, but
this is a good night.
Apparently the future of that team is in jeopardy.
Well, yeah, especially after...
I wouldn't worry too much about it.
Well, Sapphire walked out on Sugar last week, so, I mean...
Alright.
Everybody has those days.
Would you listen to this?
A mixed reaction. Sapphire Jones.
Coming out for her brother's music, ain't that something?
Yeah.
Queen B.
This was the terms the match was made under. If Sugar wins, they're back as a team.
But if Sugar loses, wins, they're going off on their own.
Yep. And obviously the more important matter, I wouldn't say more important, but I would say just as important. Winner of this match obviously will be the fifth entrant, I believe?
Yep.
Don't ask me, I've been out a couple weeks.
At least she will be the fifth entrant into this tournament.
We have a member of the Dynasty, which is, I believe, it was the kid that got entered in, right?
They gave it to Kaisera.
Kaisera entered in.
Right.
A number one seed to be named later. There's somebody else I'm forgetting, but I'm sure it'll come to me.
Right. And then you have Roxy Glock who's in already.
She won by virtue of her win a few moments ago. And, oh, Rachel Diaz.
Yes, Rachel Diaz.
Look at this. Sugar Jones firing away on the Queen Bee.
Yeah, similar situation in the first match. These two know pretty much everything there is to know about each other, we think.
I mean, the way it's looking, it's like, it seems like they taught each other everything they know, but haven't learned everything they don't know. If that makes any kind of sense.
We could be witnessing the end of a tag team right here, right now, tonight.
Ripping. So who wants to take a shot? Who's number one seed is?
I don't want to guess. No.
Remember, Morgan Rakeoff is not qualified. She's not allowed in the tournament.
Well, Vanessa Price is on deathbed right now, so I'm gonna guess it's not her.
Right. Amber Stevens, she's not in. And Sierra Knight, she's also not in.
I got two guesses.
You know who I think deserves it? The queen of DCA, Tiffany Clark.
I got two guesses. Pyra and the kid.
I think Pyra actually is a very good guess.
Yeah, I think it's Pyra too. I would. Oh my god! Wow.
Get out, Powerball.
That was a spine buster, by the way. A new side of Sugar Jones tonight.
I mean, there's a
gut wrench suplex.
There's a future championship opportunity hanging in the balance.
Kick out at two by Sugar.
Not to mention there, at least there are immediate wrestling futures.
Exactly.
Well, wait a minute.
Oh
my god. Oh man.
Wow.
I remember that. I usually hit that. Oh man, that move.
That's just...
What the hell?
Right. And
Sugar Jones. Oh, knee to the side of the head.
That's knee lift. Almost like a knee lift. Uh-oh.
Leapfrog. Beautiful blow there too, and no.
Seems like this crowd is starting to not like the actions of Sugar Jones right now. Jeez.
What a spine buster.
Sugar Jones getting all into this.
Yeah, I think this crowd is sort of split on the two Joneses here, no relation.
Yeah, half of them want Sugar to win, half of them want Sapphire to win. Oh, man.
I wonder if they, when they were attacked, they went out and introduced each other. They was like, I'm Sugar Jones, and I'm Sapphire Jones, together. No relation. Okay. I give somebody 5 points if they can get the reference.
I feel like I know what it's called. But
that's what social media is for, guys. We got a match going on.
Oh, look at this.
Exploded by Sugar.
Number 86 versus number 84.
That is 96.
96. Excuse me. My bad. I don't exactly have the best vision over here, okay?
Oh, nice.
See you soon, 10.
A kick out. Nice hook of the legs there by the Queen Bee. Face buster. But, you know, I'm kind of surprised we're seeing some really vicious moves pulled out on each other tonight.
Wow.
Oh, there goes Sapphire.
Well, as I like to say, friendship be damned in the name of championship gold.
Uh-oh, Sugar has pitched his clothesline, but no, she gets out of the way.
I have a 20 count to work with here in DCA. Both women in with plenty of time to spare.
If I had something in mind.
Super kick!
In the face!
Are you okay, Eddie?
And that was a 2 count.
Sorry, I kind of knocked off the street.
Oh, man.
Oh, good lord.
Sit down, Spinebuster. That was amazing.
Wow.
Her insides can be feeling that for about a week.
Oh, God. Not this shit.
Fallen!
305.
Oh, my God.
That's the homeland right there. 305. Sugar Jones going in for the win. 1, 2.
No! Only 2.
That's right, Sugar knows where it's at.
Oh!
You gotta get your fucking head kicked in.
Oh, Sapphire talking a little bit of junk to our Sugar there.
Come on, Sapphire, chill. Uh-oh.
Oh!
Fireman's carry. Ouch.
That will ruin her weekend.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now over! Oh, what a spine buster!
Another variation of the spine buster. Really? She really gonna do this shit again?
Yes, she is. Yes. I believe she is.
God damn it.
Woman!
You got a pro looking like Julius Irvin, though.
At least a minute.
That's alright. Oh, my!
God!
Look at that. More. That was smart.
I don't know if that move has a name, but I would like to give it one.
And going for a clothesline again? No. Sapphire gets out of the way, kicks in the gut. Uh-oh. Oh, God, on the outside. Oh, that actually is concrete.
I'm going to tell you something. Sapphire was smart. She got hit with that big move and immediately rolled outside. She's smart.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh! You guys okay? I guess their headsets got taken off. Oh man, our announce table exploded with the weight of Sapphire. And now Sugar Jones looking to end it all. Oh, knee to the gut, though.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, glad to see you guys are back.
Hello?
Yeah. Oh, man! Scissor kick! Sugar is down!
I guess we're back.
What the hell?
Can anybody
hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. What the hell
is
going on around
here? All right, come on. Focus. You guys are like autistic puppies.
Oh, my goodness.
Sapphire! Body splash!
Big splash from the top!
I think this is all over.
I think so, too.
One, two, three.
Got her!
That was that. That was it. The team stays together for now.
Well, Sapphire goes on to the tournament.
You guys think Sugar might have thrown the match out?
I doubt that.
No.
I doubt that very seriously.
Do you think the team meant that much to her?
I gotta think on that. Guess we'll have to think about that and we'll be back.
We will be back for the main event, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back to Wildcats episode 22. I'm the voice of DCA himself, Josh McLeod, alongside Champ and Eddie Mack. And guys, what a night we have had so far. Now we're about to go over the card for the upcoming mega event. And starting off the night,
it will be for the DCA Fever Championship. Yumi Nagara will be challenged by Cleopatra Sphinx and Michelle Rosberg. And not only that, it is a Road to Victory qualifying match. And if Cleopatra is beaten in that match, she can never again challenge for the Fever title.
There's so much on the line in this match.
Yeah, it'll make a bad year even worse for Cleopatra.
And the Neo Diva Revolution takes on Alika Lynch and Delia, who recently broke free the DCA Wildcats Tag Team Championships. Guys, this match has a lot riding on it. Both pride, respect, and of course, the tag team championships.
Neo Diva Revolution better watch their asses.
Neo Diva Revolution gonna get killed. And speaking of getting killed, Maybelline Rose.
Oh.
Yeah, she's about to get served at the hands of one Madison Lockmore.
This is the chance for justice to be given to Vanessa Price.
Maybelline Wolf thought she earned a women's championship match over CCR. She got murdered. This is going to be the same result.
Oh, speaking of murdering, Raindrop takes on Pyra in a match where... And Amber Stevens, my bad! Oh God, just to add much to it. Amber Stevens, Morgan Raindrop, and Pyra in a three-way match. Oh, I'm not sure if any one of these ladies is going to be walking out.
Somebody going to get hurt now.
Somebody, I'm afraid we're going to get hurt too if we're commentating that.
And then real quick, Morgan and Pyra after that match can't touch each other until redemption.
That's right. In the main event, the DCA Wildcats Championship, Akira Yukimura takes on the winner of the tournament we have going on right now. And honestly,
that's a DCA redemption.
That's the DCA redemption. My bad.
She will be taking on an opponent to be determined. Wildcats DXD coming soon, only on YouTube. Only on this here channel!
In my defense, it's been a few weeks, so You guys can't expect perfect.
That's why we're here.
Oh!
Speaking of expectations.
I can't wait. Look at this.
Oh my. Yes, this is coming at DCA Redemption.
Oh my god. Baseball, hell, and a cell match. Morgan Raincroft versus Pyro. Guys,
there have only been two of these matches in...
This is two of
tie. Yeah, there's only been two of these matches in personal wrestling history.
It's do or die that night.
Me and Eddie Mack called one of them, and I swear my jaw was on the floor when that match was over.
I've never called one of those matches before, and I'm looking forward to possibly having the chance to. As it is now time for the main event of the evening. We do not know who will be facing off, except, you know,
this
left.
This is Mark Bond, and this is the Pirate.
Oh, wait. Whoa. We have a Pirate in DCA now?
Yeah.
What have I missed?
This is quite a bit.
We have a Pirate.
Mari Pond, does she have any relation to Peter Pond? No?
I get it. But we have a Pirate.
Yeah, apparently.
Yeah. We have a pirate. I've only been booked in one match in the past year. Are you kidding me?
There you go.
Wow. Okay.
You've been replaced by a pirate.
Okay.
You've been replaced by a pirate. You shit.
Good lord.
That's why I'm kind of glad I retired from in-ring competition, so I'm not replaced by no ridiculous character.
I'm too young, though, so I got time left.
Yeah.
I'll be back.
Anyway, Mari Pond, about to take on an opponent to be determined. That is pretty much going to be the theme of these qualifying matches in the Road to Victory tournament, which is what this match is for, a spot in that tournament.
That was so repetitive. You said that basically three times. This tournament, basically...
I get it.
We have some slow fans out there. Just being honest.
Oh, who's this?
If it's
ooh,
who I think it
ooh.
Is...
Wait a minute!
It's Megan Van Horn, Mari's tag team partner.
Oh,
God
damn!
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What is it with tonight?
The theme of tonight is tag team face off.
God.
Players.
That's right.
Wow.
The theme of tonight is we're going against Teddy Long. Fuck that.
Oh, this won't be awkward, right?
Not at all.
Awkward all night, dude. We've got past that. It's all good.
Yeah, it's not gonna be awkward at all. Not just like the first two matches weren't awkward either.
Okay. No, not even a little bit.
Here we go.
It is our featured bout. It is the third qualifying match in the Road to Victory tournament. It is Mari Pond versus Megan Van Horn. She formed a tag team at DCA Emergence. They've been quite successful as a unit, these two representatives from Wrestle Parade, and here we go.
Nice front face lock there by Pond.
I went in the back of the head, and I'm pretty sure Megan didn't appreciate that too much, I don't think.
Nah, because that she's got... That, yeah, there's a receipt right there. Nope.
Oh, an elbow's blocked.
Oh, man.
Swatted away again. Kick to the hamstring. Kick to the hamstring. Three kicks to the hamstring.
Yeah, you can really knot up a hamstring with kicks like that.
Or at the very least, kick their leg out of their leg.
Yeah, exactly.
No, excuse me. I don't appreciate that. Mr. Big Shot over here. Mr. Oh, look at me. I can do the CCL. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We get it. Okay? We're near rubbing our faces. One.
Hey, be happy that you're that young and that old enough to remember that reference.
Yeah, look at me.
Be some old motherfuckers.
Yeah, you are.
Hey, you don't have to drink so fast, youngin.
All right. I'll stand my ground.
Look at this chain wrestling.
I can't not make it off the mark.
Reason I'm giving you two your time, because you know more about the CCL biz than I do.
Oh man, what a neat. And look at this. This is just like the previous two qualifying matches. Because they're tag teams, they know so much about each other. They know what the hell the other person's gonna do even before they think about doing it.
Oh!
Oh man.
Oh, pure forearm drag by Megan. Now Megan Foy is team ducks under and now Megan. Oh!
That was fun. Look at this.
Oh man.
That's got kind of suck.
Oh yeah.
Oh, nice chop to the chest by Miss Pirate Lady.
Yeah, you gotta leave the chesticles alone though. Don't mess with the puppies.
It's a wrestling move.
Don't mess with the puppies though.
I got Carter, come on.
You know what you were getting into when you agreed to call this show a show.
There is a reason that we don't have Carter commentate Wildcats anymore, and you just completely broke the reasoning behind that. God. It's all good though.
Yeah, like I said, they're paying me enough to be here. I ain't gonna be here all the time. But I can do whatever the hell I want to. But I don't want her to hurt the puppies.
What kind of contract did you sign?
It's called a shit contract. Okay. Oh man, what a face.
Now you sound like Greg Diamond. Good lord, you're a mix of everyone.
Oh, what's up? She can fuck me, like, leave the puppies alone, damn it.
Oh,
that's freak.
Eddie, you dying over there?
I grabbed a bag in my feet.
Lord.
She can't breathe at all. Her chest is a bright red.
These two old men, I'm worried they're having heart attacks.
I ain't that old, bro.
Mm-hmm. If I'm old enough to have a stroke, then yeah, there you are.
I tell you like this, both these women in the ring right now, they can take a trip to my hotel room and yeah, find out what I really am. What a bulldog.
Dude.
you are determined to get going on, too.
This is what, I apologize, ladies and gentlemen. This is what Eddie has to deal with every time we call Adrenaline and Mega Man. And sometimes Paul. This is what he has to deal with.
I can stand on Adrenaline, so I don't have to worry about it.
There's leg lock now by Dan Horn.
Trying to take the legs out of her opponent.
Smart.
Is close to the ropes, but she is, I don't think she's anywhere within arm's reach of her.
Yeah, she seems like she's a bit taller than you would think.
Man, she is just tugging on that leg. She is not let go. It's been locked in for almost a minute now.
Ligaments might be tearing at this moment.
Yeah,
this is a mission move too, but she gets out, finally.
And boy, she is a third generation wrestler, the opposite of the more experienced of the two, so she knows very well what she is doing in that ring. Oh my god, that is the glory backbreaker.
Well, there you go.
I swear to god, I saw a bunch of high school kids doing that exact same move as a stretch the other day.
Yeah, that's some new shit.
That's
that, Wait, as a stretch?
Yeah, it pops your back. It feels good.
I'll tell you what. After the show, ask Megan how that
works. All right. I will.
I can tell you how it feels right now. Probably not good.
Well, she's doing fine.
I think she's trying to give her the new man a blow her back out. Okay, all right.
She gets oh, man!
Love is blowing her back.
Stop pulling the dude. They're working on the leg.
Back to the leg.
I mean, that's a smart strategy. People don't realize that. That's a smart strategy for a person the size of Amari Pye. Amari Pye looks like she's a pretty tall woman.
Nice. Oh, look at this.
Again, the glory backbreaker.
Usually when you tell a woman you're going to blow her back out, it's actually a good thing. Okay.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Double sludge, and...
Ooh. Oh, man, that was nice.
Arm drag! Thanks much, my mind. My mind. Oh! Wow!
That was really impressive.
A snap Frankensteiner by Megan!
Ooh. That was really close to being a freak out. I'll tell you right now.
That was.
Oh, without that flip. Got the cover. 1, 2.
All right, where's the
How many times have you seen this tonight? Good Lord.
2 and no, Martin Frist again. No.
Oh, wait a minute.
Hey, victory roll. Martin Frist is it.
Oh, man. You
fell. Frist is Megan. No.
Nope.
It's going to take something big for one of these two to beat the other.
Uh-oh.
Something big or something surprising.
Van Horn up top.
Usually women like something big. Oh! Okay, all right.
Oh, come on, from the top, though!
No.
Just commentating to do, dude. Do my job. I'm sorry.
So am I.
No, you're not doing a job.
No, I'm doing my job.
What is your job?
What I'm doing now?
What are you doing now?
Being the best damn color analyst in the business.
Oh, okay, yeah, you just crossed the line. You're always gonna be second best. I'm sorry.
Yeah, okay.
First best is sitting right next to you. And it's not Eddie.
What up? You're supposed to be the voice, which means you're play-by-play. I'm color. There's a difference.
I'm everything.
I mean, and it's not just because I'm black that I'm colored. I'm, okay, alright.
I'm going to that far.
Yeah. Gentlemen, I'm sure I've played that
game. I'm trying to call you because I'm alone, white
man. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, that might be it.
That might have crushed her ovaries.
Oh, my God. That's more... Oh, my God.
That might crush her mind.
Yeah.
And her pelvis.
Uh-oh.
All right, that's on it. That's up left shoulder down. 2, 3. No.
Another victory roll.
2, 3.
Three, damn it, 3.
Bouncing off the ropes. Oh. Now I want to kick to the side of the head. Something's got to give here.
I think that if somebody makes a mistake at this stage in the game, I think that's what's going to cost them.
That's right. Wait a minute. Whoa. All
right, the paper's going to be here. No. Paper versus the 2 and 0.
Closer and closer. Hurricane Rana sending Mari, either way.
Mari.
You gotta think though, is that with these three matches that have taken place, Will these tag teams survive after this?
A little bit of friendly competition. Never hurt anybody. Whoa! Oh!
It hurt somebody. Oh my god, that was... Wait a minute.
She's going for it.
She's got it.
One, two, three. Mari Pan will continue on in her quest challenge for the title. Wow. Pirate's doing better so far in her career than I've done. Yeah, I think that tells me something.
This Pirate's doing a lot better than the Pittsburgh Pirates in baseball. Okay, alright.
Wow. Oh,
so,
man.
You know what? No, this
Van Horn was the more experienced of the two, but in the end, she was the better woman. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us tonight at Wildcats Episode 22.
He was better than East Carolina Panthers Pirates, though. Okay, alright.
Oh.
Bye-bye.
Oh, my God.
Bye-bye. Oh, wait.
We're going to find out if this team will stay alive.
I mean, that was a good match.
Come on, we've had enough betrayal in this.
Alright!
There we go. Sportsmanship!
You don't get a lot of that in this company anymore.
That is a good point.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a night we have had.
Hello!
Close episode 22 for Champ Eddie Mack and myself, the voice of DCA, Josh McLeod. We thank you for tuning in tonight.